ESPN Senior Sneakerhead, which is the best title
I
ever.
Like that.
I hope that's on your checks. Nick DiPaola. So, Nick, you brought us some goodies.
Yeah, definitely.
Right? This is the Adidas headquarters in Portland. Tracy, I know some of these look familiar.
Yes. This is two of the T-Mac lines right here.
Oh.
So we have the T-Mac 1, T-Mac 5.
Okay.
So Tracy's first shoe when he was with the Magic, and then probably his most beloved shoe when he was with the Rockets, of course, the China connection there.
Right.
Every time those come back out in China, fans go nuts, and it's a huge shoe for sure.
Awesome.
So this right here is from the first line, and it has the 175 on there. Reason for the 175 is when I was in high school, I was the last person taken in this Adidas camp. And they gave me the jersey number 175. Like, I was the last guy to enter this camp. And I left the camp playing against the top guys in the country, the Lamar Odoms and those guys. And I left number one. So this is the inspiration
behind
this.
That's pretty awesome.
You may have been the last person to register, but you were not the 175th person taken.
I was the last person to enter because I came from unknown, a small town in Florida that nobody knew about.
Well, somebody had a failure in scouting.
Right, exactly.
That would not happen today.
I don't think it could slip through the cracks.
I mean, it's fascinating, especially your era. I mean, I know there are still sneaker wars today and back and forth and certainly the Under Armour drama the past few years, but I feel like your era was like the height of sneaker war craziness. The Nike Adidas sort of assault to get you, what was that like and what impact has it had that you actually went Adidas?
Well, because I was with Adidas since my junior year in high school. You know, they sought me out then. But no, I just had a long relationship with Adidas. And it was a trial my first 3 years. I signed a deal with them. And I just felt like the partnership was great. Thank you to Kobe for opening up those doors because he left Adidas and went to the other company.
Right.
And I signed my huge deal and, you know, probably the number one guy to sell the most shoes for this company. So, I mean, it's an ongoing relationship. And now we're coming out with a totally, completely different line than what we have and also doing the retro.
So can you please tell how big a deal this is going to be All-Star Weekend?
I think the bigger thing, too, going back to when he said Kobe left, was T-Mac was kind of the first guy that brought patent leather, silver. He brought a lot of color to the All-Star game. So T-Mac 1, you had the silver black.
Mm-hmm.
T-Mac 2, you had that royal blue patent leather. And then T-Mac 3, I don't know if you couldn't decide or what, but you had one red and one blue.
So, and I think you look at today's sneaker companies, they're actually selling a different color shoe.
Yep.
And I started that back in, what was that, 03, 04?
That was 04.
04 out here in LA.
And be like, yeah, I'll wear one of each.
I couldn't decide what I wanted to wear because of the uniforms we had, the blue and red and white uniforms. And I had a patent blue and a patent red. I just said,
and the new one's coming out this weekend. You and I are doing the Celebrity All-Star Game together on Friday night. You better be wearing those new shoes.
I hope so. I hope so.
It's going to be, I mean, what's expected to release?
Well, it's not this weekend, but I know in summer, this summer in China, there's going to be some T-Mac 5s coming.
I know they don't come out till the summer,
and
but I've been told
I will have them
maybe
all.
Think he's
we can put
have
them
a surprise.
On display on Friday
Hopefully.
Night.
I think there's going to be a surprise on Friday.
Yeah.
All right. See, I'm just going to blow your surprise. I'm just going to tell everyone, you've got to see these shoes. They're so good.